y'all. I'm Sammy and this is Tommy. We are currently in South Africa staying on the Olifants River. Today we continue our safari adventure and stay in two different types of accommodation. We stay in a budget bungalow inside Kruger National Park and at a luxury safari camp on a private reserve.
Today we are leaving the Mafubu Nature Reserve and heading back into Kruger National Park.
We're going to be staying at Olifants Rest Camp tonight. It's going to be like a communal rest camp, so lots of people staying in different huts, but we have a 5-hour drive ahead of us and we're heading out now. The elephant is giving us a send-off. He came walking through our camp last night. And here he is. He's waving his ears bye to us. Okay.
Some babies in there pruning. Taking
a little time. Look at this big papa coming up behind.
I think it's a gray hornbill.
Those things that...
We were almost at Olifants Rest Camp when Jackie spotted our best sighting of the trip so far. We were able to have a close encounter with a young leopard.
Oh wow, great spot, Mom.
Oh, his tail's up.
His tail's up. He's gonna get something. He's stopping.
He press start, he's gonna kick up with his hind legs and just come in here at me. Look, oh, I freaking missed him.
The rabbit did, he missed him.
He is just covered in warts.
We'll dig a hole.
That one's weird looking.
That one is called a ground hornbill. Olifants Rest Camp is one of the main rest camps inside Kruger Park. The camp is situated in the middle of the park with hundreds of bungalows overlooking the Olifants River. We stayed in a modest bungalow with a thatched roof. The camp had a restaurant, lounge, shared kitchens, as well as a barbecue area.
This is where we're staying in Olifants Rest Camp, part of Kruger Park. This is our hut. That's the hut next to Sammy and Tommy. Down there is the river. What are we eating?
Okay, Today was our second to last day self-driving through Kruger National Park. Today we spent like 30 minutes with a leopard, which was crazy. It was the perfect way to end our self-driving trip. Tomorrow we are heading on a 6-hour drive to our next place that we're staying, which is right outside Orphan Gate in Kruger National Park, and we're going to be staying on a private reserve and hopefully doing some game drives. Our first pack of hyenas. Isn't it called a clan?
It's fun to see that hyena. Another one. Bonus.
Good lighting. He's gonna say hi to everybody this morning.
Nursing, Tommy. You see him nursing?
Leopard. No. It's up in the tree.
You can only see its little leg hanging over, but it's huge.
We arrived at Honeyguide's Rest Camp as our last stop on our amazing safari adventure. We checked in and we were driven to our camp.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, ma'am.
First time in the safari jeep.
Girl, I believe we have made it to camp.
It was quite an exciting entrance as we were greeted with an elephant blocking the path to our room.
Can you show him who's boss? Doesn't like he's backing down.
This luxury tented safari camp is found in the Manyeleti Private Game Reserve. The reserve shares unfenced borders with Kruger National Park. Our luxury tent was enormous. It had a private deck overlooking the bush. The beds were so comfortable and also featured a very convenient mosquito net. The bathroom was open-aired with hot showers. The camp features eco-friendly facilities and amenities. There is a large open-air bar and restaurant, an infinity pool overlooking the local watering hole. We were even able to see elephants. There is also a campfire area and many places to sit and relax.
All right, we just arrived at our private reserve. They had lunch waiting for us. It was delicious, and now we're going on our first safari. This place is super nice, super fancy. Out of our league, but we're gonna enjoy it.
Does it matter which car? No, it's
this one.
This one?
Yeah. Welcome on board. I'm going to be your guide. The first rule, please don't stand up on the car. These animals see this car as one big unit. But if you stand up, you break the outline of the whole vehicle, those animals can start to see us. And when they see us, they have two options. The first one is to run away. Second one is to attack the vehicle.
We're starting our first safari.
This one is called a plain zebra or Bechel zebra, and this one is having thick stripes, and the stripe from this time is joined on the belly. bulls make you with a big forehead. The bulls have a big forehead, like wearing a huge helmet. That forehead is hard like a hammer because they use it for fighting.
Enjoyed a sundowner, which is basically happy hour at sunset in the African bush. The sunset did not disappoint, it was stunning. Once we arrived back at camp, dinner was waiting for us.
I just got main thing of butter and squash soup. My main course, grilled beef celery steak dessert. Malva pudding, thank you so much.
Thank you, Chef.
Thank you, Freddie.
Yeah, boy, no head.
There it is.
Thank
Thanks, Freddie.
What's up, you guys? Good morning. So it is just before sunrise at 5:30 a.m. and we're about to go for our second safari drive.
Yeah, today is our last day in the African bush. We're gonna go head down, get some coffee, and hop in the safari jeep.
Let's go find some lions today.
I know.
Yeah, lions.
Giraffes are the only animals that can do any sound. Only sound that you can hear from a giraffe is sneezing and coughing. They communicate by the body postures. For sure, they don't have voice boxes as they're having long neck. You see, as I told you, if we seated like this, they can't see us. You see that big male just walked in front of Ezekiel. She's doing a courtship for that male.
Yeah, it's another male is coming there also.
When this male and his brothers got here, there were five coming from the northern part of the reserve, and they tried to conquer this area. One of them was in bad condition because male lions fight a lot. That's why they always limping and having problems. As soon as a male lion gets to the age of between 8 and 9 years, that will become weak as they fight a lot, competing for the female select.
Look how swollen his calf is.
I like how he's just standing there like it's no big deal. Right by him.
Go maybe to the other side, maybe we can go together.
Wow.
like an old chimney.
We came back from our sunrise safari, had breakfast, and packed up. We had such an amazing time watching animals and living the safari lifestyle, but we have more of South Africa to explore. So we just finished breakfast and we got all packed up and we were heading out of Honeyguide's tented safari camp and we were making the 6-hour drive back to Johannesburg today.